cannot go by your emotions, because your emotions will try to convince you that it's never going to work out. But somebody say that I know that all things are working together for my good. You got to talk like you know that God has already worked it out. Come on, your mind will tell you all the reasons that it's not going to happen. Your mind will tell you that you'll never be able to buy that house. Your mind will tell you that your body is not going to be healed. But you got to praise God in your midnight experience. Give me a little bit more monitor so I can preach this thing how I feel. Look how big those obstacles are, is what your mind will try to tell you. But you got to allow your spirit to rise up and say that I walk by faith and not by sight. Father, I thank you, hallelujah, that I've come into my midnight. I thank you that I've come to a new day. It may still be dark outside, but I know that you're beginning a new era in my life, and I know that the light is on the way. I want to encourage you, church, to keep a praise in your heart. Keep a praise on your lips. You may be saying, Bishop, I've done this for a long time, and I don't see nothing changing. But I want you to know that God's timing is not our timing. You got to keep on doing the right thing until you see the start of your new day. You got to keep doing the right thing, even though it may seem dark outside. You got a few more hours to go before the sun peeps into your life, because this is one thing that I learned, is that the longer it seems like it's taken, the bigger your blessing is going to be. Somebody need to shout on that right now. If it seems like it's taken a long time, you got to know that God is working on a bigger blessing. Don't be discouraged because it's taken a long time. That's just a sign that God is about to do something in your life that you ain't never seen before. Somebody ought to say it's gonna be bigger. Say it's gonna be better. It's gonna be more rewarding. It's gonna be more fulfilling than I ever imagined. That's why you got to praise God in your midnight experience. That's why you got to keep doing good to folks that mistreat you. You got to keep on giving in your midnight. You got to keep on serving in your midnight. Because I heard the word of the Lord say that weeping may endure for the night, but joy is coming in the morning time. I dare you by faith to touch somebody next to you and say good morning. Say God is getting ready to do a new thing in your life. Get ready for new favor in your life. Get ready for breakthroughs in your life. And I just heard the Holy Ghost say, he's about to give you double for your trouble. Have I got a witness in here that know you're not in the darkness of the tomb, but you're in the darkness of the womb, and God's getting ready to birth you out. God's about to birth something out of your spirit that's getting ready to take you to a new level. God's getting ready to birth a new anointing in your life. And I hear God say, get ready to prophesy in a new dimension. Get ready to see in a new dimension. Get ready to preach in a new dimension. Get ready to lay hands on the sick and watch them recover. So my challenge to you today is that, can you trust God in your midnight experience? Can you trust God when it look like you ain't got enough money? Can you trust God when your spouse is acting crazy? Can you trust God while you're in between jobs? Can you trust God while you don't have the customers yet? Can you trust God till the loan goes through? You may not see it improving, but you've got to walk by faith and not by sight, and watch God turn your mourning into dancing. Watch God turn your sadness into joy. God just told me to tell you, you're about to come out. I dare you to high five your neighbor and say, neighbor, you're about to come out. You're coming out restored. You're coming out promoted. You're coming out healthy. You're coming out free. You're coming out better than you went in. Can you offer God a praise and say, I'm coming out because I've learned that if I can give God praise, take me a little higher. If I can give God praise in my midnight, I know that weeping may endure for the night, but joy, all joy is coming right now. And I hear God say, can you praise me now? Can you praise me while you're going through it? Can you praise me while you gotta watch on live stream? Can you praise me even though you may not be in a building? Can you praise me because there's something on the inside that's working on the outside that let me know that everything is gonna be all right. It's gonna be all right. Come on, clap your hands and start praising God. Come on, clap up, O Sataya. Even in this sanctuary, I dare you to clap your hands and start praising God. It's my midnight, but it's still a new day. It's dark in there, but it's still a new day. And I believe that the chains are falling off. I believe that my mind is being renewed. I believe that as I praise him, he's healing my body. As I praise him, promotion is coming. As I praise him, a new dimension of his glory is happening right now. I want you to take about 30 seconds and give God praise. In your midnight, come on, let out a thank you, Jesus. In your midnight, come on, somebody. In your midnight, know that it's a new day. It's a new dimension. And God is working it out. Another scripture say, don't wait for the battle to be over. But you can shout right now. You can bless God right now before you see it. Before you see it. God, I bless you. God, I thank you that you're shifting things on my behalf. On my behalf. You're shifting it in my praise. You're doing it for me. Lord, I praise you for it. I thank you for it. Listen, as I close and the praise team is going to come, as I close, I want you to think about this. At midnight, most people were asleep. But that didn't mean that it wasn't a new day. Many times, when you are unaware, God is working on your behalf. It was a new day. At midnight, at 1 a.m., 2 a.m., 3 a.m., all while you were asleep with your head in the pillow, it was still a new day. Even though it was dark, even though it didn't seem like things had changed, when midnight hit, it changed. And I want you to know that some of you all, you're in your midnight experience, it's dark, but the sun is rising. And if you hold on, you're going to see the manifestation of God's glory.